During the Second World War, Scapa Flow was the main naval base of the British fleet. The surrounding islands made Scapa Flow a formidable natural harbour that protected the British ships against storms and heavy weather. To protect the fleet against the German Navy, the British had blocked the entries to the harbour with anti-submarine and anti-torpedo nets. So it would be impossible for the German submarines to gain entrance into the harbour and attack the British ships. However, German air surveillance had spotted that the Holm Sound at the northeast of the harbour was not protected by these nets. Instead, the British had blocked the sound with block ships, old, unneeded ships that were scuttled to block the entrance to the sound. Some of these ships seemed to be far enough apart to let a German submarine slip through. The task to penetrate the British defenses was given to U-47 and its captain Günther Prien. Prien left German waters on the 9th of October and headed to the British naval base. To remain undetected, he would stay submerged during the day and would only resurface during the night. The German U-boat arrived in Scapa Flow unnoticed and began its approach. Because the waters in the sound were very shallow, Prien would not be able to dive and had to stay on the surface. That was especially dangerous as he was only a couple of hundred meters away from the coast and the sound was lighted by polar light. At midnight, he had passed the barriers and was now inside the harbour. He immediately started to search for enemy vessels. After he had had no luck in the western part, he was at the point of giving up when he spotted a battleship. The Royal Oak was an older battleship that had already been in service during the First World War. Behind the Royal Oak, Prien spotted a second ship. He believed it to be a second battleship, but in reality it was the seaplane carrier HMS Pegasus. Prien, whose submarine was still surfaced, decided to attack. He ordered to fire four of his torpedoes. What the Germans did not know at this time was that their torpedoes were one of the worst weapons ever handed to a soldier in battle, as the commander of the U-boats would later describe it. The torpedoes had never been properly tested before the war, and at the beginning of the war the Germans had to find out that their torpedoes very often neither stayed on course nor detonated when they hit their target. In Prien's case, one of the torpedoes didn't even leave the torpedo tube. Two torpedoes simply disappeared. And the last one hit the anchor chain of the Royal Oak, where it detonated. The men on the British vessel didn't even consider an enemy attack, but instead they were checking the ship for an internal explosion. After he had also unsuccessfully fired his fifth torpedo from the stern, Prien ordered to reload. After a couple of minutes he could try again. This time he was more successful. Two of his torpedoes hit the Royal Oak. The British battleship started to list. The third torpedo hit HMS Pegasus and damaged her. Behind the two ships, a handful of destroyers had arrived and started to search for the opponent. The Germans also feared that they might have been seen by a car on the nearby coast. So Prien decided to leave. He left Scapa Flow the same way he had come and arrived shortly later in Wilhelmshaven in Germany. HMS Royal Oak sank with more than 800 men lost. Prien was celebrated as a hero in Germany. He had seven more patrols until his submarine went missing on his 10th patrol in 1941.